Hey y'all, I'm James Wright, and welcome to my shop. Today we are going to be looking at the depth adjuster fine tune knob, and how exactly do you fit it into here? So before we dive into this, there are also written out instructions that I have a link to down below, and you can download those offline. Really well written out by Jeff at ReedPlane, so take a look at those. But here we're going to actually take a look at the video version. First off, the knob is left-handed, so if you're trying to screw it on, unfortunately it screws off, so it's a little bit confusing. Also, that means that it won't work on some of the early Stanleys. Some of the early Stanleys are right-handed. If your Stanley does not have a lateral adjuster, or if the lateral adjuster is a one-piece Stanley mold, then this won't work. But if your lateral adjuster is like this with the two-piece riveted top, then this will work fine. Also, as Stanley kind of led the field, most of them have the same threads on there, so this will work with a lot of other brands. So we're going to open this up and take it apart to make it a little easier to get at. I like to take the frog off because it's just going to make this whole thing a little bit easier, but if you don't want to take the frog off, then you don't have to, it just makes it a little bit easier to get at the screw. Next, we're going to back the old adjustment nut all the way off, let the yoke slide on it, and then the yoke will become loose here in a bit. If you also purchased the adjustable yokes, then this would be the time to replace it. I'll have a whole other video coming out showing how to do that. Now, this can be the very difficult part. How do you get this off? And if you're really lucky, you might be able to turn it by hand, but very, very rarely. Most of the time, these are seized in there very well. I could grab a pair of pliers and just crank on it, but I'm probably going to ruin these threads. And with a brass nut, ruined threads are just no go. My normal preferred answer is actually a pair of vice grips, but I have a pair that are modified and I have a big glob of hot glue on both of the jaws. That allows me to crimp onto it without crushing the threads. Unfortunately, after 2.5 hours of looking, I can't find mine. Nor can I find my foot-powered hot glue gun to put them on this. So my next favorite solution is just to grab a scrap piece of leather, wrap it around, and then I can use the vice grips to crimp down on that. And 99.9% of the time, that is enough. Because the yoke is in the way, I have to loosen it, move it, grab it again. And usually after 2 movements, it's now loose enough that I can come in here and unscrew it. Just make sure you go the right direction, as they are left-handed screws and drive you bonkers. At this point, I can grab the new stud and thread it in place. And the nice thing about this is it comes with a slot on the back. So putting it in and out is far, far easier, as I can grab this and just tweak it down into place. I don't want to over-tighten it, I don't want to strip it out. I just need enough pressure so it's not going to move around and it's finger tight. Now we can grab our new depth adjustment knob, and remember, it threads the opposite direction of what you want it to do. And you want to move it on a little ways and then let the yoke match up with it. And once it goes in a little ways, the yoke will connect. And now you have a nice tight knob to fit in there. But as you can see, this one's still a little bit sloppy because, well, Stanley always made these yokes very, very sloppy. And that's why we have the file to fit and the wedge fit yokes. After all that, we can set it back down into place, put our screws on, and tighten this whole thing up, and she'll be good to go. Now this is going to feel really odd right off the bat, as it's going to have a lot of movement. And if you have a lot of slop in this, you might have 3 or 4 full turns to get this all the way around. In this case, I have a little bit over 4 turns. I have about 4.5, 4 rotations to go from this connection to this connection. But once it's there, I've got a really nice, easy adjustment. A very little movement on this is almost no movement at all. It's a very, very fine adjustment. So when you're used to a 16th of a turn here, you're gonna need an 1/8 of a turn to do the same. So you do a 16th of a turn with this, it's gonna do half the movement. Far more adjustability. Then as another tip, put the nut back on to the stud, and then you can put this back in the bag that yours came in, so in the future if you want it, you can look for it. Or you could try and sell it on eBay for parts, but I'm sure there's probably going to be a few others, so the price on these is probably going to go down here soon. The adjustment knob is probably one of the easiest additions that you can put onto it, and it's very, very simple. And especially with this one, the extra friction on here, the fantastic knurling, the fine adjustment on this, just being able to quickly turn it, this is, I love this. This is so, so happy. And it's one of those things that it just makes it feel good. And that's the big difference between a standard Stanley and a high-end plane. A standard Stanley will do all the work you want it to without any problems. But it's the fit and finish that you're paying for on a high-end plane. And this adds that fit and finish to the knob. It just feels good. It's got the fine adjustment and it's a very, very pleasing experience. As I said earlier, there are instructions available online, so you can go and download those. And if you like that, you can have it on your bench and while you go through it. It's a very simple addition and I really, really like this one. So if you want to purchase one for yourself, you want to see the plans, links to that down below. Also, we have videos on how to set up your wedges as well. We'll have a video soon on how to set up the yokes. So I hope you like this. If you have any questions, comments, ideas, let me know those down below. I do read through all of them and I answer as many as we possibly can get to. And on that note, I think that'll do it for now. Until next time, have a wonderful day. Sorry, but there's no yoke at the end of this video.